Today's the day. Alienware systems just arrived, and I had FedEx do a hold for me on the package, so I can just go pick it up myself, because I don't want to, it's already bounced around enough, I don't want to bounce it around on the floor in the sun in a FedEx truck for the next 6 hours. So here we go. Here's FedEx, let's go sign for it and bring it out. There you go, the Alienware Area 51. It's a lot bigger than I thought it was gonna be. All right, there you go, loaded up in the Raven. I changed the name of the car, it's called the Raven. But look, the whole, I had to put the seats down for it. This is gonna be fun. Gotta do it this way because I remember the light. I got the system home now, and it's like huge. Look at that. Just to give you an idea, I'm 5'10 and a half. This thing's about, what is that, about 3 feet? Easily. So yeah. Whew! Let's unbox.
Hey, how you doing down there? Alright, so one of the things I really appreciate about Dell and probably Alienware is the way they box things, so let's rip this puppy open.
Alright, here we go. Here's the box and the boxing, and you can see, not too bad of a job boxing it up. It was prepared to travel, so. I imagine this is software and keyboards. Look, totally gave me a hat. That's awesome. I didn't know I was getting that. The Alienware keyboard. This has got to be driving Blair Gal crazy right now. He's seeing his kin. Okay, Alienware keyboard, and I think this is the one that lights up. I'm not sure. We'll check it out in a minute. Alienware mouse. This is probably one of the biggest sells on any system. I don't care. It looks like I just bought a freaking car, doesn't it? They give me a big old manual like this. And I guess the software and stuff is in the back. But look how nice this case is. This is a leather case. You wonder why these systems cost stuff. I think it's the extras that they put in that they charge for that are the real sell on these. Another thing I didn't expect. Alienware mouse pad. I think these are for magnets of some kind or stickers. I have to keep looking through the box because I'm not sure what else is in here that's hidden that I don't know about. So I'm going to stop for a minute and I'm going to get the system up on the desk because you've seen me open the other box. If there's any super surprises, I'll show you when we get there. All right, that black thing there is the computer. It's covered up in this nice little sheath. This is pretty funny. I don't even want to touch it and get fingerprints on it. But one of the nice things about it, besides that, is I'm supposed to be able to open this up here somehow. Anyway, here's the top part where there's front side speakers and connections, including a SATA. I believe these are all USBs, four USBs, SATA, and audio and microphone. I had to look at the manual to figure out how to open it, but let's open it. So quick flip there, flips right open. This is the hard drive side. And as you can see, the hard drives are really nicely separated from everything. These drives are easy. Plug them in, plug them out. It's not hot swappable that I know, but in this generation it may be, I don't know. So that's one side. Okay, this is the other side, and there's reasons why I'm showing you this, because it's really built solid. I mean, this is like probably the best system I've ever had for now, until they up the CPUs to like, you know, 12 cores, 12 threads for a total of 24 CPUs. This one has 6 cores, 12 threads, so it makes it essentially 12 CPUs, give or take. In theory, 2 CPUs handle I guess you'd call them 6 duos. So, there you go. It is water-cooled. It's got a, I'm not going to open that. There's a card behind it, the video card, the NVIDIA card. Another nice thing that I neglected to point out in the back was the power supply. I'm geeking out over this, gang. I'm sorry. The power supply actually can come in and out where you don't have to touch any wires, which is, if you've ever put a computer together, that's a pain in the butt. But you can actually fold it down, pull the power supply out, put it back in. I'm not going to do that. We've looked enough of it. It's time to turn it on. Okay, it took a couple minutes to get it in there. I thought I was going to have a little bit more room. Again, I'm surprised at the size of this thing. It's just really massive. But let's turn it on for the first time. I was waiting for the Alienware thing to light up, but there it is. And you can see the sides. I had mine blue. You can make it any color you want, but the sides look nice blue. I'm getting it ready to use, so. Okay, so logging in for the first time ever. Kind of anticlimactic right now, isn't it? I'm hoping it makes a really good sound, although there's no more. Speakers are on. I was hoping it would like make a really good like sound, like some weird alien sound, like boop 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 boop. Something like this. I know that wasn't that weird. That was it. That's all I got. A doo doo. Damn it. Alright, in my excitement, I forgot to put the network cord in, but that's alright for right now. But this gets me. I soiled myself when I did this, okay? Honestly, I wet my pants. Ready? For those of you that don't know what that is 12 cores of processing power. 12. 12, not 4. 12. I wet myself again. In case you guys didn't know, this is what I have been working with, which is nothing to sneeze at either. It's a quad core running at about 3.0 gigahertz a second with 8 gig of memory. And oh my god, here we go. Now the real work starts. Now I gotta install everything on it, but goddamn worth it. Mighty Thor enjoying his new Alienware Area 51 souped up 12 core, well, 12 thread computer. See ya!